work to hold governments accountable and to fill gaps. Not every person that has given their time and their lives and their resources to civil society work is looking for cheap profit. I can be richer than where I am seated today if I chose to be a lawyer and not work in civil society. You must remember the history of how we conquered HIV in this country. The awareness was largely created by civil society and not government. You must remember the history of how we attained our democracy, first our independence. It was by your fathers and your forefathers and mothers who stood the Aba Women's Union, the Aba Riots, and also the coal mine workers in Enugu who said, no, we want a country we call our own. And we have maintained this even through military rule. Without civil society, we will still have military government. And perhaps General Obasanjo, now Mr. Obasanjo, might still be in power, as might Babangida. We hold this country in trust, and all the people who love this country work for this country. And we believe in the separation of powers. We believe in open governance of our country. And that for our people to say they truly have a democracy means our people must be able to organize themselves, dissent if they will, approve if they will, but our people must have a voice in governance, and that is what participatory governance is. Once you control civil society, we no longer have participatory governance. That is why the bill must not pass. And why this press conference today? We have appealed to reason time and again. We have spoken to them. And we believed at every step that because these reasons were cogent, we were heard. Apparently not. So therefore, we speak again. Tomorrow, yes, we will be marching to the National Assembly. We will mobilize and we will be there even beyond tomorrow. Let it be heard. Nigeria was built on the people who wanted true democracy. Nigeria will only be sustained by participatory governance. Thank you.